Hey guys, it's Brock Rivers, and welcome back to my FIFA 17 Liverpool promo where off Chelsea slipped up, which allowed me to go 10 points clear at the top of the Premier League table. And I did that by picking up wins over Crystal Palace and Watford. If you didn't see those matches, those are there, so please go back and watch it. But whether you did now or you've come back from doing that or you already watched, or you don't care, then you can enjoy, anyone can enjoy the my game against Southampton. And the Saints go up against a few former players like Zinedine Zidane and Sadio Mane.
Hi there everybody, Martin Tyler here along with Alan Smith, and our match today comes from the Premier League.
That says it all, doesn't it?
He could be the star turn for Liverpool today. Must be loving the season so far. He's got 15.
Three of the top five top goal scorers of Liverpool players. Especially considering Daniel Sturridge hasn't started every match. Which is
the issue really is how
sudden rush of goals. Those are a welcome sight. Making my decision to put him in place of Divock Origi. He a good decision. Here's Daniel Sturridge. Mane! Oh! Still don't know how to do that. Not celebrating. Gesture. So maybe this was the best.
International level, but not attractive enough for him, it seems.
No, it seems not. A little bit of a surprise, but perhaps it's the extra workload. He feels that he would be able to do both. And his club
goalkeeper is wearing the same colour boots.
Always been called offside.
Yep,
here.
But wearing that game. Well, their last game, they won similar colour.
4-0.
The manager would have been delighted, and I think
he might be at the end of today as well.
Trying to find
an opening.
Panicking. James Milner. Sit in. Oh, this is. His teammates in
the middle. The defender got there first, though.
Clear for a corner.
Well, that's the sort of corner that frustrates the coaches, because they obviously had plans. The delivery wasn't good.
That's what I find. Reintroduced and names coming up on above the player's head, so I can tell easily which players, which across from James Milner is headed into his own net by Van Dijk. No great start to the game for Southampton, as they are 1-0 down to an own goal. Was that or being 1-0 down to Sadio Mane? Look for the header. Van Dijk didn't get there, or he would have.
Some potential in this move. Working hard, and here's the shot. That had it.
Who's that? Bit of an optimistic shot from the. Hojbjerg, who's come over from Bayern to play for Dortmund.
And they've got it back, thanks to that slide tackle.
But like, instantly, he starts to make up for the own or by preventing perhaps a second. It was a great challenge on Firmino.
Probing away, trying to find room for a shot.
That's going to be a little consolation if Mane does. He does score. And like I said, I don't know how to do the celebration where he doesn't celebrate. So this is up to imagine that Mane is a bit of a cut.
Yeah, I don't think
you
can blame the keeper, Martin.
He celebrates against his former club.
So much space.
Which I can't imagine he'd do it. When we come to play Southampton in real life, if Mane scores, I imagine he wouldn't celebrate.
Yoshida. Cedric.
There are players
here's Cedric Suarez.
Mane, I think he was pretty happy at Southampton. Move was just too good to turn that on situation.
Broken down. Nice return pass. Cedric. It's looking good, this move. Short passes, but they're keeping the ball. Intercepted well. In strongly. It's Mane.
Here's Mane again. She must keep on him. He's not done that. Richan. Oh, Bernard came in at the right time to prevent what would probably have been in 3 if I had been allowed to turn and shoot as I was going through.
2 minutes. Oriol Romeo. He's got the ball back. Well, the defender. Well, that's half time.
And the ball is cleared to end the half. Fantastic. Big first half to put the break. Sadio Mane, not sure why he's shaking his head. Maybe he's regretting the fact that he celebrated. Yeah, you can apologize to them at half time as you're walking in and say, hey, you got caught up in the moment. See if that works. If not, okay. It's not like you're here to win a goddamn popularity contest. You're here to win a goddamn football match. Firmino, who cuts it back, Milner over the bar.
They shipped another goal.
There's a few worried faces in the crowd.
Gets his foot in there.
That might go in, but overall they have nothing to be too worried. It was a poor attempt from James Milner.
Yeah, really looking forward to it. There's two good sides coming head to head. Should have some fireworks. David Alaba. Well defended, not just getting across, he thought quickly as well. Oriol Romeo. Into the attacking third. And he can take possession in his own half.
Firmino.
This is how this team can play. Sustained attacking football, but when they lose it, as they've done
now, Daniel Sturridge.
Out of play for a throw. Daniel Sturridge, supporting player alongside.
Sturridge. Trying to make it up. Benang, and you see that got in the way at the right time to prevent probably 3-0. Maybe Foster would have saved it, but no, it looks like they can afford to take that chance. Yes. No, Southampton. Oh, my mistake. It's McCarthy in goal, not Fraser Foster.
What about Liverpool's next game?
Yeah. We could be in.
Sturridge 3. Oh, anyway. Hey, and it's game over. It doesn't post to it says my next game is. Oh, I go from one red and white striped wearing team into another in Sunderland. Eight goals for Daniel Sturridge.
3-0 they lead. Yeah, Emil Højbjerg. Just a quick check on the clock, and there are 20 minutes to go. Chan. This could be it.
Manny, clean through on goal. Will he make it 4? Oh, good save by McCarthy. McCarthy. Firmino. Daniel Sturridge. Can he make it 4? Or, oh! Ooh! I thought for a second there he might get a second chance at it, but not to be. McCarter can, for some reason, claim that, even though that looked like it was skated by a Southampton player. I could be wrong. The red and white. It, I don't know. Is that? Are those Liverpool? Ishida? I don't remember having a player named Ishida.
We've got 10 minutes left on the clock. Bertrand.
Could be just me.
That is a foul by Roberto Firmino.
Really? Oh, go. Just go away. Just go away. Absolutely go away. He's gone up to 79. When did he do that? Whatever. Bring off Sturridge as well. He's getting a bit tired. Go off and ask him the glory of his goal that has for sure wrapped up the points.
Comes in with a tackle.
Southampton were to get a consolation goal, and the fact that I can't keep that in, it's a great job to her in the final.
He's threaded the path through neatly, and it's the goalkeeper's ball quite clearly.
Take Glorious Karras and lash it down the pitch.
This has been called a football match.
Rudy. First side, Homer. Hey, he can give it back to the. Divo Origi, who cannot get there. That would have been a bit of a nail in the coffin. That Divo Origi can't pounce on what would have been a pretty easy chance, to be honest.
Here's Højbjerg.
It's not going to matter because there is a full time whistle. 3-0. Well, another. And the own goal from Van Dijk and the Sturridge and Mane. He goes. Sealing the win.
Middlesbrough 1, Chelsea 2.
Now I move on to Sunderland.
Let's have a look at what those results mean for tonight's league tables. At the top of the table remain Liverpool with 36 points. In second, Chelsea with 26 points. In third, Manchester City with 21 points.
Next train session, I'm going to take one or two of those guys out for a while. In
sixth, Everton with 17
points. You came up and then missed the golden opportunity, mate. So, if you say he played well, I'll say I believe you.
Second bottom, Leicester City with 11 points. Third bottom, Sunderland with 11
points. It's not going to make much difference happens, because it's not going to change the starting lineup for the game against Sunderland. Only an injury would do that. And no such injury has happened, so same lineup. Same lineup, different day. Yeah, as it were. It's giving me a lot of penalty drills with David Alaba. I don't know why.
Every one of you to today's game. I'm Martin Tyler, and the biggest welcome for me is Alan Smith alongside me.
I've yet to even get a penalty in this career mode.
Liverpool against Sunderland.
I've conceded one, but won one.
Yeah, 3-0, comfortable for them.
Maybe y'all will win this match. Who knows? That's just the beauty. Who knows? You never know.
Maurice Karius is the goalkeeper today. David Alaba starts with Nathaniel Klein as the wide defender.
Yes. If I actually tell Nathaniel Klein to run in the right direction, and that would, maybe, yeah.
This is the Sunderland team for you today. Germain Lens starts with Fabio Verini in the wide position.
Jermaine, of course, I thought I was drawing some nails, but of course. This game is still, well, got that little bug. Look where it switches you to whoever the fuck it feels like.
Lost his marker there cleverly.
Doesn't seem to want to go away.
Shot gets blocked. Fabio Borini.
I don't exactly expect. Good. Let's see. To say the least.
See what he was trying to do, just stretch the opposition.
Can't catch up to that ball. That does that for a throw to Sunderland.
Two games, which was a contested streak, maybe not quite the winning mentality that they need.
No, but you wonder whether the draw here would be satisfactory, whether they take that now.
Roberto Firmino.
Firmino.
Really trying to use the full width of the pitch here to make some progress. And out wide, they were in a good position until that defender acted very promptly and decisively.
He makes sure he doesn't go very far. Coutinho! Imagine, that would have been a fantastic goal.
Well, it's not been easy for Manchester United since the departure of the great.
Again, it's randomly showing me Manchester United. I don't care.
A lot of points still to play for, but they've been less than important.
Last time it did that, I had a game against United coming up. This time I don't. I don't play United again until January. We are in November. That's a good few months away.
Look throughout the side, and it's full of top class performers, and all the players just exuding confidence.
Could be dangerous.
Alaba, Sturridge can't keep his header down. Oh, never mind, it wasn't his header. Yo, oh! Pickford got lucky. Yeah, that came to, Kone instead of Matip.
Spotted that well. That
was different. There's good work. Alright, Chan. Whoops it. And the poor ball, but ends up winning again. Him
just below his normal high standards.
Corner. So
so far you can see there.
Mina. Oh, doesn't control it as well as I would have liked. Sewell. Oh.
Would have put them in front.
No goal for the big German, but faulting for a lack of effort, so damn sure.
Lee Catamon. Good football between these two. Nice passing. Patrick Van Aanholt.
Oh, great. Worked up right there, Hilko, and who kind of did a 1-2 himself. Oh, not sure how he did. That Sturridge, if he shoots instead of taking his touch, that she might score. Or at least he's forces him instead of giving it to the keeper. And Emery checked and goes for glory.
Celebration there.
Long shots not working as well as they did last FIFA.
Well, we're halfway through, and we haven't yet got a goal to bring to you. 0-0 at half time. Well, he's been in the game. Referee just checking everything is in order, and he blows for the second half to start.
A pretty poor excuse for a kickoff, and they might be punished. Sadio Mane! Oh! Sunderland almost punished for their pathetic excuse for a kickoff. Off.
There goes the cross.
Daniel Klein whips it in. It's going to come back to him. It's come to Mane. You can't put it in the net.
Soon for you on EA Sports, coverage of the quarter-final of the EFL Cup fixture. Liverpool, they'll be facing Middlesbrough.
Yeah, and I've got a feeling we might see a few goals in this one.
Well, activity on the Sunderland bench.
Lens.
And the ball broke free. Sharp
piece. It's the ball somehow to Van Aanholt. It just run right past Germander, Milner. Thank you. Somebody took the ball off of someone there. Sturridge.
There
you go, Sturridge. Placed the ball across. Didn't get to who I wanted to get to. I wanted it to go to James Milner, but it never got to him. That short corner, Sire. And he's not going to abuse the defense if he's not fouled by his own player! What the hell? Oh wait, he won a book! Oh! He won it back and Pickford pulled off the save of the match. Fucking hell. I think it was Chan who fouled him for some reason. But clear Sunderland didn't like this short for them work the ball into the box. Oh, seems to be catching them out, so I'm gonna keep doing it as long as it's working. If it ain't broke, don't fix it, ladies and gentlemen. And there's a try and tested rule. Again, my own players are fouling me! This time it was Daniel Sturridge fouling Coutinho! Why? Why are you fouling your own teammates? That makes zero sense!
Just looking at Sunderland, what about their next game, Alan?
Alaba.
Their next match.
Pulls it back for Coutinho! Are you for...
To make the save!
No, wait. Go over to the team. I'm making a substitution. Who am I bringing on, though? Firmino is tired as hell. Put Manny back there and bring on Divock. I could bring on Jorginho and Alba.
Well, if this ends up being a win for this goalkeeper...
No, I'll bring on Origi. See if he can't need a goal like me. Coutinho. Works his way into the box again, and another save from Pickford. For fuck's sake. Why is Pickford goddamn Superman? I love they still haven't figured out with this. Oh, I thought Sue was trying to freaking foul Coutinho. He almost did as well. A brief put-off may have cost the goal there.
Look how quick he reacted.
Coutinho. Oh, Origi! Surely! Bury it, Divock! Please! Oh, for fuck's sake!
They've set it up well for the cross. And it'll go into the middle now.
It's come to Sturridge. That's a poor header. At least it's apparently gone off of, I think it... I'm not sure who... for the, third go with me. Sadio Mane. Emre Can will win another corner. Sadio Mane! Come on! Oh. Sturridge couldn't prevent the... No. You know I'm getting desperate when I'm trying to prevent my own corners. Mane! I'm pretty sure that hit Sturridge. Oh wait, it didn't. He was just in the cluster and it looked like it hit him. Maybe it didn't, it hit him defender as well. It's come to Riggy! Oh, imagine! He was offside. It wouldn't have mattered. It wouldn't have mattered in the slightest. Riggy! Yes! An easy tap in for James! Oh! No! No! I've dropped points. I've legit dropped points. Wait! Let me have one more attack, referee! Please! Philip Coutinho! No! Yeah, dropped points. Wait! He still hasn't finished the game! No! No! Don't give a free kick! No, don't give a free kick! Damn it! Wait! He still hasn't blown the full time whistle! No, there it is. Ah, I dropped my... Fuck's sake! I wonder who... Really? Nathaniel got... I fucking refuse to believe he got the highest rating. 7.4! 10 saves, and you give him a 7.4. That's a joke.
Arsenal 1, Bournemouth 0. Burnley 1, Manchester City 1. Chelsea 1, Tottenham Hotspur 1. Hull City 2, West Bromwich Albion 2. Liverpool 0, Sunderland 0.
I'll see you all in the next episode. Until then, thanks for watching. I'm Joy Dental. So I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.